Welcome to our lesson on Moivre's Theorem. The goal is to use Moivre's Theorem to raise complex numbers to any power. So Moivre's Theorem makes raising complex numbers to powers very simple. If r times the quantity cosine theta plus I sine theta is a complex number, and if n is any real number, then if we take this complex number and raise it to the power of n, it's equal to r to the power of n times the quantity cosine n theta plus I sine n theta. So this is a very interesting result. This value of n is used for the power of r, but then it's multiplied by theta to find the new angle. Let's see if we can determine where this formula comes from. One way would be to just start with a complex number in trig form and square it, or multiply it by itself. And this will remind you of the product of complex numbers in trig form. Of course, we'd have r times r squared. Then when we multiply this out, it would be the same thing as we saw in the previous video for the product, except now the two angles are the same. So when we apply this sum identity for cosine, since angle A and angle B would be the same, we have theta plus theta, or 2 theta. So we'd have the cosine of 2 theta here. And the same for the sum identity for sine. Since the angles A and B would be the same, we would have the sine of theta plus theta, or the sine of 2 theta. If we take this z squared and multiply it by another z, as we see here, we'll end up with r cubed, and then the cosine of 3 theta plus I sine 3 theta. So what we're noticing here is that the power that z is raised to is used on the power of r, but then it's multiplied by theta to find the new angle. And this pattern does continue. Another way to take a look at this theorem would be to use Euler's theorem, which states e to the power of I theta is equal to cosine theta plus I sine theta. So of course it would follow that r e to the I theta would equal r times cosine theta plus I sine theta. Before we show the next step, what we should recognize here is that our argument theta ends up as the angle for sine and cosine. So now if we take this and raise it to the power of n, this is r to the first power, so we would have r to the n e to the I n theta. Well, now our argument is n theta instead of theta, so now we could say this would be equal to r to the n times cosine n theta plus I sine n theta. And this is Moivre's theorem that states that this raised to the power of n is equal to r to the n times the quantity cosine n theta plus I sine n theta. Let's go ahead and see if we can apply this. We want to rewrite this in rectangular form, but what we'll do first is evaluate this using Moivre's theorem, and then we'll convert this to rectangular form. So this would be the same as 2 to the third power times the cosine of 3 times 3 pi over 4 plus I sine of 3 times 3 pi over 4. So we can see our angle is going to be 9 pi fourths. So we'll have 8 times cosine 9 pi fourths plus I sine 9 pi fourths. Let's take a look at the angle 9 pi fourths. 9 pi fourths would be coterminal with an angle of 9 pi fourths minus 2 pi. Well, 2 pi is the same as 8 pi fourths. So this would equal pi over 4. So this angle is coterminal with pi over 4. So we'll use that as our reference angle. This is 45 degrees in the first quadrant. So we have 8 times the cosine of 9 pi over 4. That would be 1 over square root 2, or square root 2 over 2 if we rationalize it. And the same for the sine of 9 pi over 4. 1 over square root 2, or rationalized, that would be square root 2 over 2. So we have 4 square root 2 plus 4i square root 2. So you can see if we convert to rectangular form first and then try to cube it, it would be a lot more work. Now we have a complex number in rectangular form, raised to the fifth power. We want to use de Moivre's theorem to compute this. So we'll convert this to trig form, and then we'll raise it to the fifth power. Now I include the unit circle here because it's going to help us dramatically. Remember, for this complex number, a is equal to 1/2, and b is equal to negative square root 3 over 2. Even though this is the rectangular coordinate plane rather than the polar coordinate plane, we can use this to determine theta. Remember, on the rectangular coordinate plane, a would be x and b would be y. So when x is 1/2 and y is negative square root 3 over 2, we're actually right here, where our angle is 300 degrees or 5 pi over 3 radians. So that's helpful. Let's use 300 degrees. Next, we're fortunate because that's actually the point on the unit circle. Therefore, r would be equal to 1. Remember, this is all we need to write this in trigonometric form. We have 1 times the cosine of 300 degrees plus I sine 300 degrees, but we're taking this and raising it to the fifth power. So using de Moivre's theorem, we'll have 1 to the fifth times the cosine of 5 times 300, that's 1500 degrees, plus I sine 1500 degrees. Let's go ahead and take a look at 1500 degrees. Let's find the least positive angle that is coterminal to that. So what we'll do is we'll take 1500 degrees, divide by 360, so we have 4, that's 1440. We have a remainder of 60, so that tells us that this is coterminal to a positive 60 degree angle. So since we already have the unit circle here, we're actually going to use this point right here to determine these function values. Well, 1 to the 5th is equal to 1. Cosine of 1500 degrees, remember on the unit circle that would be the x-coordinate, so we have 1/2, plus I times the sine of 1500 degrees, well, sine would be the y-coordinate, so we have square root 3 over 2 times I, or I square root 3 over 2. So there we have it. This is that complex number raised to the fifth power. So as you can see, again, if we tried to raise this to the fifth power in rectangular form, that would be very difficult to do. But once we convert it to trig form and use de Moivre's theorem, it actually is very straightforward and a lot easier. I hope you found this video helpful. Have a good day.